Today we will discuss parts of speech. What is parts of speech? Just think about the fact that we use thousands of words, and every word we use belongs to one of the 8 word groups or parts of speech. We put the words into groups based on its job in a sentence. Think of parts of speech like a job of a person. A person can be a doctor, teacher, engineer, lawyer, farmer, etc., isn't it? In the same way, a word can be noun, pronoun, adjective, adverb, verb, etc., depending on the job it does in a sentence. So, what are these 8 parts of speech? So, there are 8 word groups that we just discussed in the previous slide. So, the 8 parts of speech are noun, pronoun, adjectives, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. What is a noun? A noun is a name of a person, place, animal, or thing. Person, it can be a boy, it can be a girl, it can be your mom, your dad, grandma, grandpa, Mrs. Jones, who is your neighbor. Or place, your school, your home, your playground, the zoo. It can be animal, dog, bee, frog, cow, lizard, thing, book, flower, shoe, pencil. What is a pronoun? Pronouns are words that replaces noun. I, me, she, we, they, who, that, yours, his, her, it, etc. Now, in the sentence, see the example. In the sentence, Advai saw Meher and he waved at her. The pronoun he and her take the place of Advai and Meher respectively. So every time we are not going to say Advai, Advai. Every time we are not going to say Meher, Meher. Instead, we are going to use the pronoun. Instead of these nouns Advai and Meher, we will say he and her. What are adjectives? Adjectives are describing words. An adjective is a word that describes a noun. Now we will go through some examples. Funny clown. We are talking about a person. That funny, he is funny. Hot desert, a place. Broken egg, thing. So it is describing. How is this clown? Funny. How is the desert? Hot. What has happened to the egg? It's broken. It is describing these nouns. Smelly garbage. Thirsty camel. Quiet library. Old man. Pretty princess. Quiet search. Sleepy dragon. Sad boy. Now, what are verbs? Verbs are action words. They are doing or action words. You drive, you walk, you talk, you jump, you write, you run, you swim, you read, you are eating, you are writing, you are playing, you are digging, you are talking to your friend, you are drawing, you are laughing, you are waving to your friend. So all these, your actions, all these are actions, isn't it? So these actions are verbs. Verbs are action words. What are adverbs? Adverbs describe how a verb was done. The chef cooked happily. Now, this cooked is a verb. So, how was the chef cooking? At that moment, he was happily. He was happy with his work. He was happy with the job he was doing. So, he cooked happily. How often the verb happened? So, cooking, how often it happened? The chef cooked daily. Every day he used to cook. Where a verb happened? Where? inside or outside. The chef cooked outside the house, not in the kitchen. When a verb happened, at what time? Today, tomorrow, yesterday. The chef cooked yesterday. What are conjunctions? Conjunctions are special words that join words or group of words together just like a glue. What does a glue stick do? It joins, isn't it? In the same way, conjunctions will join two words or two group of words or two sentences and make it one. For example, pizza and burgers are my favorite snacks. You are going to say pizza is my favorite snack. Then again you will say burger is also my favorite snack. And then you join them and you will make it pizza and burger are my favorite snacks. I am very hungry but the fridge is empty. I am very hungry. The fridge is empty. Join and make it one. I am very hungry but the fridge is empty. There is nothing. I don't have any food to eat. She usually eats at home. She likes cooking. She usually eats at home. One sentence. She likes cooking. She usually eats at home because why she eats at home? Why she don't go out to a restaurant? Because she likes cooking. You can have peach ice cream or a mango ice cream. So we are joining. You can have peach ice cream and again you are giving an option that you can also have a mango ice cream. So you join and make them into one sentence. Now we will discuss preposition. What is preposition? A preposition is a word that tells us where something is. For example, this cat. See in the second picture, there is a cat and there is a box. Now, where is that cat? Sometimes the cat is inside the box. Sometimes it is above. Sometimes it is behind. Sometimes it is under. Sometimes it is close to the box. Sometimes it is in front of the box. So all these words describe what? The position of the cat, where it is. So this type of words are prepositions. What are interjections? Interjections are words used to express some sudden feeling or emotion. We use these words interjection many times when we out of fear we use or when we are very happy or when we are very sad or when we experience pain or surprise or we make a mistake. So we use these words. Your friend come and gives you a very good news and you react by saying, wow, that's really great news. That wow is the interjection. Hooray, I have passed the exam. You are so very happy and you react how? By saying hooray. So that is the interjection. Then you can see in the second picture, the words, the interjections that we use and when we use these words.
So, let's recap now. There are 8 parts of speech, right? Noun. What is a noun? A person, place, thing or idea. What is a verb? An action or state of being. What is a conjunction? A word that joins together words, phrases and sentences. What is an adjective? A word that describes a noun. What is a preposition? A word showing the relationship between a noun or pronoun and another word. What is an adverb? A word that describes a verb, adjective or another adverb. What is an interjection? An exclamation usually at the beginning of a sentence that shows emotion. What is a pronoun? A word that takes the place of a noun.